All right, was it a lose-lose situation? ESPN under fire after the network reassigned an announcer who was supposed to call a game in Charlottesville. Why? Because of his name.
Yeah, Robert Lee is the announcer. Robert E. Lee was the Confederate monument at the center of the violence in Charlottesville nearly 2 weeks ago. ESPN felt that that was just too close for comfort and might upset some folks at a sensitive time. Right call or wrong? You tell us. Go to care11.com/vote now to weigh in on what you think about this in real time. Here's Lindsay Sievert with the story.
We welcome you here to UB Stadium. Robert Lee and 12-year NFL veteran Tyoka Jackson joining you. Perfect night for college football.
Who could have predicted the collision of headlines when this Robert Lee, an emerging ESPN play-by-play announcer assigned to Virginia's college football season opener, would appear in memes and Twitter posts next to that Robert E. Lee, a Confederate namesake. After the Charlottesville tragedy and Robert E. Lee suddenly back in the news, that's what ESPN feared would happen if their employee, with a coincidental name, worked the Virginia game. Thus, his reassignment to another game and the backlash the network tried to avoid in the first place.
When I saw that the first time, it felt to me like something from The Onion.
To Mike Zipko, a public affairs consultant and owner of Zipko Strategy in St. Paul, ESPN's decision is a self-inflicted wound.
And then you find out it is true, and then you find out, well, ESPN didn't want to offend anybody. Well, in their effort to not offend anybody, they almost offended people's common sense. So it's like they overcorrected before they needed to correct. And now you have the situation where they're on the defensive. They're explaining all day long.
Zipko advises organizations in crisis.
Because sometimes doing nothing is the best thing to do. And in this case, you might argue that ESPN not doing this, it might have been better. Maybe you had a few people mad about the guy's name, but you would not have what you have right now. If someone's going to complain, maybe you have a message or two ready. You have a statement or something to send to people to respond to them. But accept the fact that it's almost impossible today to be in a situation where someone's not going to be upset or offended. Because I think whatever counts as being offended now, that bar is really low.
He also sees this controversial decision creating future problems for ESPN.
Is there a lesson learned for other organizations? I'm sure other people are watching.
I think a couple of lessons. One, have some people outside of your world that you can talk to.
Get good advice, he says, outside your own bubble.
As opposed to the entire internet. So that might help you in the future going forward. I also think this might be a good kind of a check for people that the sensitivity has gotten a little far. If a name can be deemed as offensive, we're in trouble. And also I think what's sad is sports was a place that, I mean, it was never totally free of politics, but it was freer of politics than it is now. And you watch a football game, you go to a football game, there's people from different walks of life.
So what is in a name? After a sports network's fumble, there's so much more than letters and labels.
A lot of new faces on both sides of the ball.
It's history and future.
Unfortunately, I think they're going to become like a test case for other people, like, would you do this or don't do what they did, which is not a place you really want to be.
Now, Zipko told me from a PR standpoint, this creates secondary news stories that stretch into other days. People now seeking interviews with Robert Lee and possibly drawing ESPN into the banter of late night talk shows.
Oh, for sure.
So you can imagine the ripple effects, but maybe there's an argument for it. I don't know.
Their hearts and minds might have been in the right place. Absolutely. And you live in 2017, you're like, oh, this might make people upset. I get that. I get where ESPN's coming from, but it.
I just think you made much ado about nothing, and now it's not nothing anymore.
But get to game day, and Robert Lee is there standing outside, and people start to complain then.
Asian Robert Lee?
Then nobody's confusing him with the actual dead Robert E. Lee. But
how many people would have really noticed?
I don't know. That's the question. We'll never know that. Yeah. We'll never know that. I think ESPN was wrong. I just want to give, I don't think they meant any harm.
Right.
But yeah, difficult times. Twitter's going to get you.
Yeah, the sports and politics argument that is here to stay.
Absolutely.
Those worlds have blended the Venn diagram.
Sure enough has. Yeah, he was spot on. Mm-hmm. Good interview. Yes, thanks, Lindsay. Appreciate it.
Thank you.